Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. This is video number 107, and I am going to discuss mastering strata commands and do file. In this video, I am going to use a practice file. I have named it as practice data with extension DTA, and this file has 400 observations on four variables. Two of the variables are categorical. One is admit, and I have labeled it as one stands for yes and zero for no. And then another categorical variable is rank. It has four ranks. One stands for very high, two stands for high, three stands for medium, and four for low. Then there are two scale or quantitative variables. One is graduate record examination score, and the other one is grade point average, so GPA. So two are categorical variables, and two are quantitative or scale variables. I am going to use various commands in this video. I will tell you how to label a variable, and then how to remove labels from a variable, and then I will use to analyze categorical variables and the quantitative variables with the if command. Today I will show you how to use a if command with quantitative data, and then I will also show how to make a do file with the command in strata. So I hope this will be a new experience for you. Ladies and gentlemen, now I will open my strata file, and as I told you, here I am using this file with the practice data dot DTA, and I have already opened this file, and let me show the data. This is the first variable, admit. 0 and 1 categorical variable or dummy variable. This is the graduate record examination score, and this is the grade point average in the last examination, and this is a ranking of the institute in which the student has studied previously. The number of observations in this data set is 400. Now I would like to first of all close this, and here I am in the data file. Now there are no labels here. I will label these variables, and then I will remove these labels from variables. But before that, let me tell you, it is very important that you make a do file and save it in a safe place, so that you can use this later on with these commands, and strata will execute all these commands. So the command for do file is write do edit. If you press enter, strata will open a new file for you, and this is untitled. You can copy command from the review window, and you can copy into this file, and then you can save it with some name. I have also made one do file. I'll use that file. So this is how we can make a do file, and then we will save this file with a specific name, so that we can remember the file name. Let me show my own do file to you. I have already made a do file. Since my practice data is in strata, the name of the file is practice underscore data dot DTA. So I have also made a do file, and the name of this do file is do file practice underscore data, and I have saved this file with this one. So this is my do file. I will use this later on. Let me start with the labeling of the variable. So I can copy this command from here and paste here in the command window, and then pressing enter, it will execute the command and it will label the variable. So let me copy this from here and copy. I will paste it here, and then I will press enter. So you see the variable admit, which was previously unlabeled, has now been labeled, and one is equal to yes and zero is equal to no. So one means that admit, and zero means do not admit. Let me also label the GRE variable, and I can write label variable GRE, and I will write GRE score. So let me see what does it do. You see here it has been labeled now, right? Similarly, I can click on this, and here instead of GRE I may write GPA, and then here I can write grade point average. And after pressing, the variable GPA has now been labeled grade point average. Similarly, I can also label let me label rank, and here I will write one is equal very high, two is equal high, three is equal medium, and four is equal low. Now if I press this, this variable has been labeled here, and you can see the labels here. Now I want to remove these labels. So how to do that? Let me first of all click on this, and I will remove all this. If I remove and then press enter, hopefully the variable rank will be unlabeled. Yes, you can see. Similarly for the GPA, I can also delete this and I will press enter. Now here the GPA, the label is grade point average. Now if I press OK, the GPA variable will be unlabeled, so the label is gone. Similarly, I can also unlabel or remove label from the GRE score, and now the label has gone. And similarly for the first variable, which is admit, let me remove this, and pressing, so all the labels have been gone now. But let me show again how can you label these variables. There are two ways. One is by typing the command here, and the second way is to use the file menu, data, and within data if you go to data utilities, then label utilities, and then label variables. And if you do this, let me first of all do for admit, and here I will write 1 is equal to yes and 0 is equal to no. So this is the drop menu command. If I say okay, now the variable admit has been labeled. But instead of using this drop menu command, let me give direct command and to label the data. So I have already the command here. Let me press and enter. So the variable GRE has been labeled again. Similarly, for the GPA, I will press enter and it has now been labeled again. And similarly, for the rank, this is the rank variable has now been labeled. There are 4 ranks. Now this is how to label a variable or how to remove label from variables. Now I want to show you some simple data analysis with the command. And as I told you, I have 2 categorical variables. So one is admit and one is rank. So first of all, I gave this command tab and admit. Now if I do this, it will make a frequency distribution. So here is the frequency distribution. The total number of frequencies for 0, that is no admit, is equal to 273, and this constitutes about 68% of the total. And similarly, 127 are those who are admitted, because the code for this is 1 and 1 means yes. And that constitute round about 32% of the total, right? Now I want to make another tabulation of the rank, and there are 4 ranks. So here is the frequency distribution of this data set by rank. Now the number of observations, are the number of students, are the number of individuals in rank 1 who studied in rank 1 college is 61. 151 studied in institutes with rank 2. 121 studied in institute with rank 3, and 67 studied in rank 4 institute. The total number of observations is 400. And these are the percentages. 15% of the students studied in high ranking institute. About 38% of the students studied in high ranking institute. 30% of the students studied in medium ranking institute. And 17% of the students studied in a low ranking institute. And the last column shows cumulative frequency. Now let me tell you, I want to make the frequency distribution of the rank with if command. So I will write tab rank if. If admit is equal to 1, sorry, this should be double equal to 1, and sorry, tab rank if admit equal 1. Sorry, this is not working for the variable. So now let me let me make a two-way table of admit and rank with the chi-square test value. So this is the cross tab of two categorical variables. Column wise we measure rank of the institute in which the students has previously studied, and row wise we are measuring whether the student was admitted or not. These are the column total, these are the row total, and this is the grand total. And this is the Pearson chi-square test with 3 degrees of freedom, and its value is 25.24, and its associated p-value is 0.000, and this p-value implies that there is a strong association between the rank of the institute and the admission of the student. Now I have two quantitative variables, one is GRE and one is GPA. Let me summarize GRE and GPA. So it will give me a summary of these two variables, and in a summary there will be mean value, standard deviation value, mean and max values. So here is the summary of GRE and GPA. Total number of observations for both the variables is 400. These are the mean values. The average or the mean GRE score is 587.7. This is the standard deviation, this is the minimum, and this is the maximum. And this is about GPA. The average GPA is 3.39, its standard deviation is 0.38, minimum of GPA is 2.26, and maximum is 4. Now I want to see the same summary but only for those if admit is equal to 1. So let me, yeah, now you can see there is one difference between this table and this table. Here there was no condition, so the total number of observations is 400. But now I made a condition, and I want to ask Stata to give me a summary table of GRE and GPA with the condition that admit is equal to 1, that is if the student was admitted. So it means that the number of observations when the student was admitted is equal to 127. Rest of them were not given admission. But now the average GRE score is 618, and its standard deviation is 108. Minimum GRE score is 300 and maximum is 800. Similarly, the average GPA is now 3.48 with standard deviation of 0.37, with a minimum GPA of 2.42 and a maximum of 4. Now you can see here the average GRE score is 587, but this is for all 400 students. Some of them were admitted and some of them were not admitted. But here the average GRE score is 618.9. This is almost 619, and this score is higher as compared to this score. This is because here we have included only those observations who are admitted. Since the GRE score is considered for admission, so the average GRE score is higher here. Similarly, the average GPA is also higher as compared to here. Now I also want to see the summary for those who are not admitted. And you can see, for those who are not admitted, the GRE score average is 573. This is even less than the overall average GRE score. And similarly, the average GPA score of those who are not admitted is also less than the average GPA for the entire sample. So this is how we can use a admit condition with the if command. Now let me see, can I use more than one condition? So again, let me summarize GRE and GPA. So I will have again this table, the original table, this one. This is exactly the same as here. Now I want to give this command, and let me ask if admit equal 1 and rank equal 1. Now I want to ask stata to give me a summary of GRE and GPA of those who are given admission and those who studied only in the very high ranking institute. So pressing enter gives me this table. Now look at these number of observations. This is 33. The overall observations are 400. But now I made these two conditions, and by imposing these conditions, the stata analyzed or gave me a summary of these two variables, but now stata included only 33 observations. So it means the number of students who got admission and who studied in a very high ranking institute was equal to 33. So 33 of 400 students were those who studied in a very high ranking institute, as well as they got admission. And the average GRE score is 636.36, and the average GPA score is 3.54. Now let me also see this for those who didn't get admission but they studied in a high ranking institute. And now the observation further decreased to 28. Now let me check this for those who are not given admission and who studied in a low ranking institute. Now the number of observations is now 55. So it means there were many who studied in the low ranking institute and who didn't get admission. So the average GRE score is 562.91 and the average GPA is 3.29. So let me also make another condition. Sum GRE GPA if admit equal 1 and rank equal 1 and GRE greater than or equal to 600. So this time I imposed three conditions. So now let me check, can stata also summarize these two variables? Yes. You see, I gave three conditions. I am asking stata to summarize for me these two quantitative variables, one is GRE and one is GPA, with the if command. The first condition is admit is equal 1, that is those who are admitted, those who studied in a very high ranking institute, and those who got GRE score equal to or greater than 600, so the number of observations now is 21. And with these three conditions, the average GRE score was 701.91, and the average GPA was 3.60. Now let me also impose one more condition, and I ask the strata to include GPA GPA equal to 3. I can use less than equal to or greater and equal to. Let me check it. So this time it is not communicating, because the number of observations for such conditions are 0. So let me check if I can do this for 2.5. again, it's not executing this command, so because there is a no such student who meet all these conditions. So now let me remove this one, and let me check. 2.5 greater than or equal to 2.5 GPA. So you see, when I gave this command, now I have 32 observations. Now the mean GRE score is 635, the average GPA score is 3.57, and so on. Let me also impose the fourth condition and write GRE less than or equal to 500. Yes, so it means we can give more than one, and here you see I have imposed four conditions: admission yes, ranking very high institution, GPA of greater than or equal to 2.5, and GRE score of less than or equal to 500. So there are only four observations. Now this is very interesting. I have not seen any other software in which I can analyze data in such a way, so that I can use so many conditions. Strata is very powerful software, and you can use it for data analysis, and you can think, you can use your mind in what sense and in how, in what way you want to analyze your data. Let me also check my do file. If I have left something, I will do that for you. Now here I show this to you. You may copy it. This is the labeling: variable number one, admit, rank, GRE, GPA, and then the label variable GPA. Then I have removed this. Then this is tabulation of admit and rank. This is chi-square, and then this is the summary of GRE and GPA, and I have also calculated the coefficient of correlation between GRE and GPA. I'll show that to you. And I have summarized: sum if admit is equal to 1, summarize if admit is equal to 0, and so on. I will leave it here, and you can copy these commands, and you can play around with your data set, so that you could analyze your data. The last command in this do file is do edit, and if you write this command here, do edit, then strata will automatically open a new do file for you. Now let us suppose I want to copy all these commands from here. So let me highlight and click right, copy, and here is my new do file, and here I will paste, and now this is my do file. This is my do file. Don't forget to save your do file. Let me temporarily save this as a do file 2 for practice data. I give this name because this name because this do file is associated with the practice data. Practice data is my file in Stata in my computer. So let me save this. Now the do file has been saved. Okay, so let me copy these commands, and I can use these commands in Stata later on. This is my Stata, and if I now you see I copied, I pasted the commands that I had saved in a do file, and I pasted here, and then I pressed the enter. So all the data were analyzed for me again in the way I had done already. Now ladies and gentlemen, this is very much interesting. I hope you like this video, and if you like this video, you can share this with your friends, with your colleagues, and with your students, so that they can also get hands-on experience on data in Stata, data analysis in Stata. If you want to get this data set, I have it here, and let me see. I will share this file in my Facebook account in Applied Economics. Let me go to, I will share there, and then from there you can download the file. So let me go to Facebook. Sorry, I don't have Facebook here, but I will share this with you somehow. The data file name is this is practice data. I have this file here, and somehow I will make it available for you online, so that you can play around with this data. This is exactly the same that I just used. You see these four variables, and then you can label these variables, you can remove these labels, then you can summarize the data, you can make the frequency distribution, the cross tabulation, the chi-square, and so on. Ladies and gentlemen, I thank you for being with me. Have a good afternoon.